Dave Stafford. I'm originally from Washington, D.C. I've lived in the states of Virginia, West Virginia, Florida, and Louisiana. Before I came to Xing Wei, I was a professor at a liberal arts school in Louisiana. And I have taught also at a medical school and in a graduate school. My PhD is in psychology. I studied a part of psychology concerned with drugs and the brain and how we learn about our experiences as well. And so I have taught courses in psychology, also pharmacology, neuroscience, history, economics, anthropology, and I've team taught with other professors in other disciplines too.
And why did you ultimately decide to teach at Xing Wei?
Well, when I heard about the idea of starting a liberal arts college in China, it just seemed like a really interesting opportunity. I have two young sons, and I thought the idea of moving to China and learning about China, allowing my sons to grow up and learn Chinese, was a big factor. But for me, the idea of starting a college here, it sounded challenging. I like to start things. I've chaired a department and overseen development of other things in college. So starting something, it intrigues me. And this sounded like a really interesting thing to help start.
Mm. And describe the course that you currently teach at Xing Wei, the topic, some of the assignments.
Okay.
Describe one of the courses that you teach currently at Xing Wei.
Okay, well, I have taught several courses here. And so I'll give you a kind of list and then tell you more about one that I'm teaching right now. I've taught Introduction to Psychology, Psych 101. I've taught Introduction to the Liberal Arts. I've taught a course called Communication in the Digital Age, which is about the evolution of communication technology and how to be a good public speaker. I've taught a course with an English professor on insanity across cultures. And currently I'm teaching a course called Money and Banking Across Cultures, and that's with a professor in political science. And so that course, for example, is one where we read from different books. We don't have a textbook. We're studying ancient evolution of money into coins and paper money up to the present day and the financial crisis and its effects in the modern day. So assignments are reading book chapters, but also watching documentary movies. Tomorrow we're going up to Shanghai, the Shanghai Museum, to study the evolution of money in China. And so courses here are very discussion-based, seminar style, and everyone gets an opportunity to say something about what they think about the assignment. And I think the discussions are partly unique because you have Chinese students and American students and American professors, and our points of view are fascinating when they weave together.
Mm-hmm. That sounds really interesting. What are the major differences from your perspective as an instructor between teaching at Xing Wei and some of the other colleges in China? What do you think the major differences might be there?
Well, one of the major differences I just alluded to, that is how big a class is. This is a seminar style class, so we don't have any classes of more than 15 students. We expect everyone to contribute to the conversation, and to learn, in my opinion, is to actively engage, not to sit in a huge lecture hall listening to someone drone on for an hour or two. So most Chinese universities are like the big lecture hall mentality. And we have nothing like that. There would be no lecture hall courses here.
Okay. And what do you feel is the most important thing that an American student can get out of an experience of studying abroad at Xing Wei?
Well, it's a powerful insight into China. So before moving here, I had read a lot of books on China. And so I knew something about China, but it doesn't compare to the experience of living here. where you meet Chinese people, get to know them as friends. You're in an environment where people are speaking Chinese around you. The language, the written language around you is Chinese. Now, there is English enough for you to function, but you're in a different culture. And furthermore, Shanghai is the, well, in my opinion, it's the most interesting city in China. So its history is a mixture of Western European and American cultures and Chinese culture. So when you go into Shanghai, you are experiencing the future, basically, where China and Western Europe and America come together. So a person who comes here, they would never be the same person afterwards. Their mind has been open to what China is really like, and maybe they can see themselves working somehow with China in their career.
Mm-hmm. And what is your message to students currently who are planning to study abroad at Xing Wei? What would you tell them?
I would tell them to come join us, because this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. So starting something in China, like a liberal arts college in English, it's not happened before, and maybe other colleges will follow us later. But this is an opportunity to be a pioneer, to participate in something that's unique. There's nothing else like this in China. Mm-hmm. So if you have the opportunity, I would just say take it.
Mm, that sounds great. Well, thank you for your time.
All right, thanks.